Oh, g'day Scrappers. Yeah, just wanted to do a little video on removing gold fingers and in some cases gold pins from various different components that we get out of eWaste. Raymond on YouTube showed me a video of a guy removing gold pins off RAM sticks very easily using just the a cheap soldering iron with a flat blade. Now I've got a few of these soldering irons, but all of mine had a sharp pointy blade. So what I did is I just put it under the grinder and just created a little flat tip so I could use this to remove the gold pins and obviously fingers. So I'm not really sure how good it's going to turn out on the video, because my camera is doesn't really have very good zoom settings. It's just it's a GoPro, so it's kind of just got set settings. So I've got it underneath a magnifying glass, so hopefully that will make it seem look a little bit closer. But so you're going to have to excuse the occasional wobble of the magnifying glass. But anyway, let's get into it. It's a really simple idea, and it's actually quite an effective idea if you want to remove the gold pins off your fingers rather than cutting the fingers off and having your whole fingers. Now, it doesn't necessarily give you 100% gold, just gold plating, because underneath the gold, the first thing they do is they put copper, and then they plate the gold on top of the copper. So underneath your fingers, you've actually got a little bit of copper still. So it's still going to need to be treated like pretty much anything to separate that copper from the gold. But here's a little example. If you can see, these are two fingers that I removed off a circuit board. And this one on the right, that's the gold plating side. And the other side, and that's the underneath. And you can see it's a different color. In a lot of cases, it'll be red or slightly brown. And that's the copper. So even though we can easily now remove these gold fingers off the board, we've still got a little bit of copper that we're going to have to, you still use some kind of chemical process. And it doesn't necessarily have to be using aqua regia or whatever they use, nitric acid, I meant. We can probably use a little bit more less toxic materials to separate the copper from the gold. But basically, this one, what you can see there is 24 karat gold, and that is pure copper. So if we can separate the copper from the gold, we've basically instantly got pure gold, pure copper, without the other rubbish off boards. So that's my little soldering iron. I'm just letting it heat up at the moment, get it nice and hot, and I'll just remove some of these samples that I'm going to be trying, and just to give you an idea. And I've also kind of discovered a really good use for these that's going to, it's going to help me a lot anyway. What I want, these things here, as we all know, they're from LCD monitors and televisions. We call these finger strip boards. Now, so we've got the fingers all along here, and you can see the gold around the edges here. Well, that's not gold plating, that's gold flashing. It's very, very thin, and using this system here, we're not going to be able to remove this gold flashing, okay? But these fingers, they're actually gold plated, so we can remove these fingers from these boards. Now, that's going to be really cool, because as most of you are aware, these finger strip boards just don't sell for much at all. So basically almost a low grade board or a mid grade, depending where you are. So if we can remove these fingers nice and easily without damaging the board, we could still probably sell these boards as low-grade boards. And we've got bonus fingers. So I'll show you that too. The video that I saw, it was basically just removing the fingers off ram sticks. Now, one thing that I noticed is you'll probably be familiar with some of these kind of ram sticks where they've also, not only have they got fingers, but they've also got these little bits of gold all the way down. Now, that too is also gold plating. It's not flashing, so it's thicker, but it's a little bit harder and a bit messier, but we can actually remove these too if we really wanted to try. But so we'll give it a go anyway, and we'll see what we can we get. All right, so I think the soldering gun, it's they're only cheap, you know, 10 bucks if that. You can pick them up from your hardware stores. You get all different types. You only really need a cheap one. And some of them come with different style chips, tips. So, you know, you want one that's got that flat kind of tip on it. And if you can't get it, you can always just do what I did and just grind it down, because I didn't want to go out and buy any new accessories for something that I already had. So I'll just give it a go. And we're going to start with a ram stick. Now, I hope you can see this, because I'm working about 6 inches underneath the magnifying glass. So, but even then, it doesn't seem like it's close enough. But so, basically, we want to remove all these fingers, yeah? I think this should be hot enough now. And it's a very simple process. Okay, so we just... we get up to there and we just skim along. Now, as you can see, we've removed all the fingers. Okay, let me keep going. Bear with me. But you can just sort of run it, run your soldering iron all the way along. And remove all those fingers. They can be a little bit sticky. I'd imagine that if you did this, by the time you did about 50 or so ram sticks, you'd get really good at it. I've only just started, so I'm not that good at it yet. But you kind of get the idea. Now, you know, we're always trying to look for better ways to do things. So, and, you know, ways to improve current methods. So, you know, I'm not showing you the textbook way to do this. I expect some of you to give more tips on how to improve it. But as you can see, there's no fingers left. They're all gone and they're down there. Other side, same deal. If we can, it's just a little bit awkward because I'm trying to do this under the magnifying glass, so I can't really get a good angle. But I'm just trying to give you a good example. So as you can see there, so we've got fingers. Remove fingers, and it's really easy once you actually get the swing of it. I'm a bit shaky and a bit nervous, so, and even these pieces along here, you can actually remove these too. So we'll give it a go. Yeah, I haven't got a good grip on this soldering iron, but it's removing very fine fingers. You can see there's no more fingers there, and they're just very tiny little pieces, and you can barely notice these ones, but you can notice ram. I'll get another ram stick. Okay. Now, obviously, there's so much gold on these RAM. There's all these little gold things. So what most people would do would be to depopulate the whole board, remove all these IC chips, all the little MLCs, Cs, and resistors, and process the whole RAM stick. But this is just another alternative. If I can just... So as you can see, I've just sort of just run it straight along. It's really quick and really simple. A bit more. So that gives us the nice and clean board. Now, let me just put that down. Okay, so if we can get closer to these fingers. Now, the ones that you can't see the gold, you might see that they've got red underneath it, and that red is copper. So we're still going to have to obviously separate the copper from the gold, but if you do enough of these, it should, let me just move this around a bit. It should give you quite a bit of gold to actually process quite easily. And if you know anyone that actually enjoys refining gold, well, this is going to be a lot better than giving him gold fingers, okay, with the board intact. So all you're going to give him is just the gold foils with a little bit of copper on the base, rather than giving him, you know, a piece of circuit board. And that, and even if you sell trimmed RAM, say RAM without the fingers, well, you've got a little bit extra board on there now because you haven't actually cut anything away. So now, slot cards, okay, are another thing. We can sell complete as a slot card, or some of us like to trim off these fingers, but here's a really cool way. So I can just get a start, and the gold fingers off the slot cards virtually just peel off. Okay, and so under these fingers also we've got red. So, and there we go. So we've got clean, and we'll go on, continue on. Yeah, just trying to get a start. Okay, now just like motherboards, these blue slot cards, the plating is very thin, so it's only cheap. So I'll get a better one to give you a better idea. Okay, so we've got a more higher end slot card from a server board, and as you can see, these fingers are really nice, thick, very nice gold fingers. Watch how easy these ones come off. You can get it. They just, it's amazing. They just peel off. So I don't know if this is going to really help anyone, you know, but I suppose if you're storing fingers, you know, you're already one step ahead by not having to remove the you know, if you cut this off, you've got to remove the gold foils off the board. So this is a really easy way. It'll probably really speed up the gold refining process. Okay. But they peel off so easy that you think, well, how did they stick on in the first place? Because they're really stuck. And but adding a little bit of heat to them and they just fall off. So it's really amazing that they're actually on there in the first place. I'll get another RAM stick. Maybe I've got my mojo going now. Look at that. All the way along, just simple as. Got a few stuck on there, but really easy, and the whole line all removed. Other side. Just get a good line. That's really, really easy. Child play this. And, you know, there's very little fumes, but there still would be a little bit of fumes. So I've got a ventilation above me. You know, you might want to do this outside, which I would do if I was going to do a whole lot of them. Now, this is the one that I wanted to show you. And this is really cool. Let me just get rid of some of this stuff. Now, yeah, as I said, the finger strip boards are something that you sell really, really cheap. Now, if you don't, you know, you can clean these boards and process this whole thing in your chemicals. But, you know, if you just wanted a quick gold recovery product, and because remember, this is flashing. So I'll show you, flashing is so thin that it's not going to come off. Alright, and that's how you can tell it's not gold plated. It's gold flashed. It's like spray painted on. So it's so thin that it's not going to come off. Whereas you've got these gold fingers, and these are gold plated. And you'll see, simply because the way they come off. Okay, now they're only very, very fine fingers, right? But they do come off, and you do get very, very fine little gold fingers ready to process to go to the next step. Now, even these ones might have a little bit of copper underneath, so they're still going to have to go through the same process of removing that copper from the gold. But I reckon that's really cool that... sure, we can sell these. Like, I'll sell these now, and just to get rid of them because they build up too much. And but before I sell them, I'm going to remove all these gold strip, the whole finger, and then sell the rest. And they can keep the flashing, and they can do what they want. I might even pick off a couple of MLCCs because sometimes you get some really nice MLCCs on them. Okay, so I'll get a blue one. Might be able to see this a bit better. And we'll just start from here. There you go. They're very, very fine and light, but hey, it all adds up. And I reckon this is an awesome thing to use on these finger strip boards, LCD TVs and monitors, because they're so cheap. Man, that felt good. It was just so easy. It's probably the easiest thing I've ever done. And so here we go. All those fingers removed all the way. And there's the start of the new fingers. So all that's gone. And as you can see, we can still sell this board, get rid of it. And we've got all the main gold. They can have this gold flashing, that's not going to go nowhere. They've got to dip the whole thing in solution, right? All we want, we've got the cream of the crop. Okay, and it's only a little bit, but it adds up, and it's 24 karat gold, because clearing it off. A few other things I wanted to show you. CPUs. We've got green fiber, brown fiber, We've got black fiber. We've got these really chunky copper heatsink CPUs. They're the, usually the AMD kind of ones. We've got your common Pentium 4 kind of things with the pins. And these are all, now you've seen people use a heat gun, and they put a heat gun and then they and tap it off. The difference between a heat gun and a soldering iron is this is 30 watts of power. A heat gun pumps out 1500 watts of power. So your electricity bill on a heat gun is just going to, you know, blow you away. Whereas this uses very, very little power. And so you're not going to waste money on electricity to get the same job done. And it's kind of fun. So let's take most common fiber, green fiber. All we want are these gold pins. Okay. Now, I'll actually get rid of these foils because we don't want to really put the pins with the foils. The difference is these foils have got copper. These pins will have solder. So they'll have tin solder, lead solder, some kind of solder that's not copper. So just in case we don't want to contaminate one with the other, I think it's a good idea for me anyway that I keep them separate. So just hang on a sec. All right. Watch this. You want to talk about easy? Now let me just clean this tip. All right, here we go. Now, you might hear the vibration against this steel, but I'm not actually using much force at all. I'm just sort of pushing it along. A little bit heavier than you would push a pen, say. And they come off so easy. And I think the really good thing about this, excuse me, instead of using a heat gun, is that all the solder, a lot of the solder stays, whereas a heat gun, you remove all the solder with the pins. So these pins are going to be a little bit cleaner than if you were to use a heat gun, because they don't have as much contamination from the solder that you have to treat before you're actually going for the gold. And again, they just come off so easy. It's just amazing, and it's actually real fun to do. And it's the sort of thing that if you spent a couple of fun hours, you're gonna end up. And if you've got the product, you'll end up with quite a lot of beautiful pins ready to be processed. And it's quite safe because what we're not doing is we're not melting the actual fiber. When you use a heat gun, you're actually burning the plastic coating and everything. And it's not very good for you or the environment. Whereas this is really limiting the amount of, burning anything that we don't really want to heat. So there we go. We've got a perfectly clean green fiber now that we can, there's still a little bit of, a gold, there's some precious metal, there might be a little bit of platinum in here, who knows, but that's okay, we don't go that far anyway, and maybe someone will actually buy these anyway. So here we go, there's all our gold pins just from that one CPU, beautiful. All ready to go. Now these ones are very common. Now once we remove these pins, we can actually peel away the plastic off this heavy piece of copper. And this is tinned copper. So you can sell this as tinned copper, probably even throw it in with your burnt copper, but solid copper, so there is quite a bit of value there. So here we go. Too easy. And again, it might sound heavy, but I'm actually not putting much force into it at all. Amazing. All right, beautiful. See, and we continue on. We'll just clean the whole lot off. Then we can peel this off. We can get to the copper piece underneath. Sometimes they just, there we go. So that's all solid copper, tinned copper, tin coated copper, whatever you want to call it. Good heavy piece. Nothing really under there. You got some resistors running around, okay? But for a average refiner, you're not going to get much more out of this. No point in trying to dip this into solution to get that little bit of plating, because you've got so much contaminants that you're just going to use up too much solution just to get that little bit, right? So once we get these gold pins and then we get this piece of copper, we've pretty much got all the value we're really going to be able to get out of it anyway. And then we got the common small one. Same deal, copper heatsink. We've got the pins going all around. Too easy. I mean, you could do this. I could do this all day, you know. I just need like 100,000 CPUs and I'll be right. Beautiful. And there we have it, you know. Very easy, using a $10 soldering iron. There's you know, very little fumes, quite safe. Recommended still do it outside or in the garage with a bit of ventilation, but it's going to be a lot safer for you. But yeah, these foils surprise me the most. Some of these foils, they come off so easy, it's unbelievable. All right, let me just move this camera around. Okay. But yeah, these foils surprise me the most. Yep, so I can't wait till I get really good at it, till I can, when I can actually do a lot of these really quickly. But yeah, so here, we've only got a few bits of gold, you know, so there's no point in cutting off all this finger just to keep a few little pieces of gold there. We can just peel these off really easy. Yeah, like I said, I'm pretty hopeless, but I'm just trying to show you doing. But let's try something different. Okay. These foils are a little bit kind of different. They're sort of like, they're doubled, they're two-way. Thank you. Okay. Cleaned. Gold. Quite easy. We just keep building up these foils. And this is just a few that I've just tried out now, but you know, that would be really nice to send to a refiner to further process. You then only have to send a very small package and you're getting maximum gold recovery out of what you're posting out. So that's it, guys. Get into it. Ram sticks, very easy to process. It's really fun. Get all your gold foils. Well, that's using the very cheap and easy soldering iron with a flat tip to remove your gold pins from lots of things, finger strip boards, slot cards, RAM, and obviously off your CPUs. All right, guys, well, that's what we got with the soldering iron. I hope some of you go out there and try this soldering iron and come up with even better ideas. ideas that are going to help other people out. I think my claim to fame on this concept is these finger strip boards. I think it's just a brilliant way to get your value out of them, and then you can still sell the board as they are and just get rid of them. But yeah, I think it's going to be awesome just to be able to remove all those fingers. Really cool. Ram sticks, another easy thing. If you just want to go for the quick and easy gold off your fingers, obviously there's a lot more gold to them. You got IC chips, but yeah. Still something fun, interesting, and I hope you enjoyed it. All right, well, that's the best I got for you. If you've got any ideas on what else we can do with these soldering iron, you know, put a comment in. If you've got any other hints or tips or anything, just let us all know. We're all going to learn from each other. So, well, have fun, and I'll catch you next time.